Kia ora mai te iwi, ko mārei kura nē pia tōku ingoa.
Ko kaile nē pia tōku ingoa, aka ko papakei.
Ko te aumārama nē pia tōku ingoa, and we are a whānau who lives by a kaupapa-driven lifestyle.
My family and I, we have developed a innovative wānanga called Hawaiki Kura, which helps our rangatai, our pakeke, and our men and our women reconnect to te ao Māori and showing the importance and the value for cultural identity, te reo Māori, me ona tikanga. Leadership for us is something that we teach within our whare wānanga, and a successful leader is somebody that serves their community. From a non-Māori perspective, sometimes it's about you being the boss.
So I think with my leadership, culture plays a very big part, as I learned a whole bunch of my values and my leadership from marae, from growing up on marae, and from my Māori culture.
The strengthening of cultural identity is pretty much at the heart of everything we do here at Hawaiki Kura. For too many of our people, through colonisation, Māori culture has been seen as the bad point of ourselves, where it's actually our superpower. And what we want to show our whānau, and in particular our youth, that using your cultural identity is a bonus.
I think these kurahuna, these superpowers that we have, strengthen our cultural identity because it provides an opportunity for our rangatahi to dig within themselves and help and hold themselves with confidence. Wherever they go, they can call upon their Māori tanga to help guide them through this forever changing world. Haka fusion is the fusion of te ao Māori, and for us it's salsa dancing, and it's all about whakakūngia te reo, so making our Māori tanga cool and fun and relevant for our youth.
Matariki for me is a real important time, and in particular in a modern day context, it's about us reclaiming and re-indigenising our spaces. For far too long, our Māori history has been written and taken out of the history books. And so it's great for us to come together to celebrate something that is unique to us and still being able to share that with the rest of the world.
那我主要的工作呢，是在撰写课程模组，从原住民的文化课程里面去撰写我们的相关的教案。那对我来说，文化的实践非常的重要，是因为它承载了我们的知识体系。那这个知识体系一旦被建构的话，我们自然而然很清楚的会有自我认同。当我们的文化被建构了之后，我们自然而然到外面就很清楚的会知道说我自己是谁，我的文化具备了什么力，我的文化具备了什么核心素养，文化而来知识而去。 像在土版部落保存了非常完整的记忆的文化，那记忆文化的实践者会是谁呢？当然就是文化记忆保存者，我们称之作布林鸟，就是所谓的巫师。为什么会觉得他们是我们的典范？因为我们必须透过他去跟神界、灵界去做对话，然后所有的祭典的仪式跟 所有的过程都必须透过他们接受到了这么多的学识跟知识，然后还愿意回到部落做文化实践的动作，对我来说，他们是非常伟大的。那文化在我的生命过程扮演非常重要的角色，因为它是我的族群文化。那么透过文化的实践，我会更清楚知道说我是土版部落的排湾族，我是谁，我来自哪里，我的家乡有什么特别的生活方式，承载着排湾族的嘎古当，我们的惯习。 因为部落有非常深厚的祭仪的文化，还有保存非常完整的祭典的仪式。我们的文化它具备了什么样的核心素养，并且实践在我们的生活之中。现代的生活中，去透过转译，让更多人去认识我们，理解我们。我当时的方式是透过表演的形式，还有交流的形式，有很多非原住民族群的人来到我们部落去游学，或者去画电线杆为部落服务这样子。在他们的学习的过程呢，我们族人在导入我们的文化仪式在这个活动之中，透过这样子的交流，让他们更了解我们，让非原住民的族群更认识我们的部落，更认识我们的族群。